60, y vamos a pasar inmediatamente al inglés. Now we're going to switch immediately to English because we have a host. We've got a guest, David Bennett from AAA. So we were reviewing the planning for this week show, and we came up with the list that you put together about the best cars to commute in the U.S. And it's a pretty good angle. And I mean, we see a list all the time, but this is a pretty good angle of having something to give information up to the buyers of what are the best cars to commute to work. And you said in your report that 86% of Americans use their car to go back and forth from home to work and all that. And again, price of gas is one of the key factors on that. And that apparently was the key factor in your study too, right?
It was one of the factors. We also looked not only at gas prices, but also safety and reliability, and then also comfort. As you're spending upwards to 25 minutes each way going to your destination, you want to ensure that you're going to be comfortable when you arrive at that destination.
Yeah. So let's start reviewing the list. And probably for some people it's going to be a surprise, because some people still don't believe and don't have too much trust yet on this alternative fuel car. So the first car that you mentioned is the Chevy Volt.
Yeah, the Chevy Volt is a very good vehicle. I think most people would be surprised when it switches from electric to gas. It is seamless. You really don't even know unless
exactly.
You happen to be looking at the dashboard, but it is a very solid car.
Yeah. And this car, when you compare it with others of its size, the MSRP, the price, is a little bit high, but what you get out of it, it's a lot in terms of you can basically don't put gas ever.
it is a flex or a plug-in electric vehicle, so meaning it has a certain length of time for electric, and then it switches over to a gas motor, so it's not an all-electric vehicle. There is a little bit higher of a price tag on this vehicle. However, there are also government incentives that you qualify for or could qualify for, and that could lower the cost to you.
Yeah, and those incentives can be different from state to state. And I actually remember when the Bolt came out initially, they were telling about, like, if you live in some certain city in California and work for a certain company, and you can qualify for a lot of incentives, not only the federal one.
That is correct.
Yeah.
So yeah, I definitely look at your state and also the federal incentives.
Yeah. So the next car is the Prius V, another hybrid that it's much more affordable, actually.
It is, and it's very comparable to the Chevy Volt. The Toyota Prius has been around for a long time, and it is another good, solid vehicle.
Yeah. Something interesting in this compact category is you include a diesel from Volkswagen. And Volkswagen, I mean, all the Germans are really ahead in the diesel technology. The Volkswagen Jetta Sports Wagon TDI, what did you include in there?
Well, I think it's another alternative that consumers need to consider. So you have, your normal internal combustion engine. Now you have your hybrid, your electric vehicle, but also don't forget diesels. Diesel engines are very good. They get good gas mileage. And it needs to be part of the consideration of consumers nowadays.
Yeah, and again, as is the case with the Bolt, the diesels are a little bit more expensive to begin with, and the actual fuel is a little bit more expensive, but on the long term, you really save a lot, right?
You can, yes. The gas mileage on diesel engines typically are a little bit better than a normal internal combustion engine.
Yeah. In the sedans category, you include the Audi A4, the Buick LaCrosse, the Ford Fusion, the Hyundai Genesis, and the Nissan Altima. And this is very interesting because a couple of American cars like the Buick and the Ford Fusion, which are coming back very strong, right?
Very much so. Both of these cars are very, I hate to use the term solid, but they are very good solid vehicles, and they come with multiple features, so you can add and delete features that you're looking for. And I think, again, as you mentioned, the Ford and Buick or GM are on their way back. If not, they're already back, I would say.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, the Fusion is doing really, really great. It has won a lot of different awards around the country in different auto shows and all that. So the Fusion has a very different, it has the powertrains. It can be electric, completely electric, it can be hybrid and all that. So there are also a lot of options for buyers.
Very much so. And I think one of the things we were looking for in the sedan category is let's look at a wide range of vehicle prices.
Yeah.
So in this area, you know, we're running from something from around $20,000 all the way up to about $32,000. So there's lots of choices for consumers out there.
Yeah, and this segment actually is probably the one that has more cars competing against each other. So yeah, there's definitely a lot of to look for.
Agreed.
Yeah. Crossovers, another segment that is exploding really. And here another Ford product, the Ford Flex, which is a car that some people is one of those that you either like it or you don't, really. And then the Toyota Highlander, this is the new one that you include in there, the one that they show in New York, or this is the 2013 model?
This is the 2013 model.
Okay. So the Flex is a car that, again, that some people don't like their style, but also it has the option of the EcoBoost engine.
That is correct.
Which is really, really a great technology that saves a lot of fuel. And the Ford Flex starts around 26,000 and can go up a little bit higher when you equip it with that. But can you comment a little bit about these two cars, please?
Yeah, the Ford Flex, you are correct. It does have a love-hate look to it. You either love it or you hate it in some cases. So, but it's one that's a flexible vehicle. I mean, that's really where the term flex comes from, because yeah, it can carry quite a few passengers, or you can use it for just running around town. So I do like that vehicle. The Toyota Highlander is another good-sized vehicle, sits on a good platform, and it is very comfortable on the highway when you're driving.
Yeah, and if you include the 2013 model in your list, I'm sure you're gonna next year you're gonna include the new one that they just showed in New York in the Auto Show a couple of weeks ago.
Well, we look forward to test driving. Yeah, and seeing if it measures up.
And one thing is that Toyota designs were a little bit boring to some people, and now they're coming up like really aggressive in that sense and making them much more modern and really, really great great products. So, and the last category that you include in your report is the minivan, and the winner is a Honda Odyssey. It's funny how Chrysler basically invented the minivan, but then the Japanese manufacturers took over that segment, right?
Well, the Chrysler Town & Country or Caravan is right up there. There's nothing wrong with that vehicle. It's solid. The Honda Odyssey stood out to the reviewers just a little bit more, and that's kind of why it's set up in this category. But it is another solid vehicle and gives you a lot of flexibility with being able to fold down the third row seats and make them flat. So you can carry quite a few passengers, or if you just need two or three to carry, it allows you that flexibility.
Yeah, and as the case with the Highlander, Honda introduced the new Odyssey in New York, and this one, did you see that? It includes a vacuum cleaner in the back already integrated. That's a great one of those things, like, why did I didn't think of that, right?
Yeah, exactly. You know, it's one of those things that you always need as you're spilling things or as you're putting things in and out of the trunk area. It's like, I need that vacuum cleaner. Where
it's exactly.
Never there when you need it.
Yeah, when things happen immediately. A friend of mine actually told me that he just bought one like 3 weeks ago, and it's already a mess. They said, I wish I can have the vacuum cleaner there because my kids make a mess every time they go in. So David Bennett, can you please share with our audience where can they find more about AAA, all the information that on services that you provide?
I'd be happy to. So there's a lot of information on AAA.com, or you can also download the AAA Auto Buying app through iTunes.
Yeah, that's great. Well, thank you very much for your time. Very interesting study about what are the best cars to go back and forth from work and go home here in the United States. And again, we're going to list all we'll publish the link to your story so an audience can take a closer look at that. Thank you very much.
Thank you. You have a great day.
Thank you. Pues ahí tienen a David Bennett de la AAA. Un estudio interesante, sin duda, sobre todo porque han incluido, como lo mencionábamos ahí en la entrevista, autos con diferentes tres motores. Han incluido el Chevy Bolt, que es un... Algunos llaman eléctrico, en realidad es el auto funciona con el motor eléctrico todo el tiempo, pero tiene un motor de gasolina que genera electricidad para impulsar el auto, así que en realidad funciona siempre con el sistema eléctrico, aunque tiene motor de gasolina, un híbrido, el Prius B, un diésel interesante, el Volkswagen Jet Sport Wagon TDI, y luego en los sedanes, como lo mencionamos, el Audi A4, el Buick LaCrosse, el Ford Fusion, el Honda Genesis, el Nissan Altima. En los crossovers incluyeron la Ford Flex y la Toyota Highlander, el modelo 2013, y como lo mencionábamos ahí, se presentó en Nueva York el modelo 2014. Y finalmente, en la lista de los mejores autos para ir y venir del trabajo de la AAA, acá en Estados Unidos, la minivan Honda Odyssey, también del 2013, y el 2014 fue presentado lo mismo en Nueva York, y es la que, como decíamos ahí con David, de la AAA. Ahora incluye una aspiradora integrada completamente en la zona de carga, en la parte trasera, lo cual ha sido en realidad uno de los temas más comentados después del Auto Show, porque es una de esas cosas, como le decíamos ahí con David, ¿por qué no lo pensé antes? Una idea muy, muy innovadora, muy práctica sobre todo, porque siempre se necesita estar limpiando el auto, y es una de las cuestiones más básicas del mantenimiento, mantenerlo limpio y ordenado, porque a fin de cuentas, cuando lo vendamos, vamos a tener un mejor valor de reventa en nuestro auto. Así que, como mencionábamos ahí, vamos a incluir la lista completa de la AAA para que la puedan ver y revisar en nuestra página de facebook.com/autos060. Y no se vayan, que cuando regresemos vamos al Auto Show de Fort Lauderdale y una entrevista con el presidente de la Bentley para todas las Américas. Esto es Auto 060, yo soy Javier Mota.